friends, welcome to Simplifying Maths. We are going to see a new chapter, that is Microorganisms, Friend and Foe. First, what are microorganisms? The living organisms around us, which we cannot see with unaided eye, are called microorganisms, or they can also be called as microbes. How can we see these microorganisms? Microorganisms can be seen with the help of a magnifying glass or microscope. These microorganisms are classified into four major groups. These groups are bacteria, fungi, protozoa, and algae. First, bacteria. Bacteria are single-celled microorganisms found everywhere, mostly. These do not have distinct nucleus, that means they are prokaryotes. Size varies from 0.2 to 100 microns. Examples of these bacteria are spiral-shaped bacteria, rod-like shaped bacteria, and spherical-shaped bacteria. Next, protozoa. Single-celled eukaryotes that are commonly shows characters associated with animals are called protozoa. Eukaryotes is nothing but they have well-developed nucleus. Examples are amoeba and permeation. Here you can see the permeation. Next, algae. It is found in wet and moist places mostly. It is a multicellular filamentous organism. Examples of this algae are Spirogorgia. Here you can see that Spirogorgia. Fungi. Fungi are the large group of microorganisms that grow on dead and decaying matter. They are also used in decomposers. Examples of these fungi are yeast and aspergillus. Even mushrooms are a group of fungi. Here you can see aspergillus. Next, viruses. Viruses are microscopic, but way different from microorganisms. These viruses are smallest microorganisms which develop inside the cells of host organism. These viruses are type of microorganisms which show common elements like common cold, cough, flus are caused by these viruses. Serious diseases are caused by these viruses like polio, chickenpox, hepatitis. Next. Where do these microorganisms live? Microorganisms live in all types of environment. They are also found inside the bodies of the animals, including human beings. Some microorganisms grow on other microorganisms, while some exist freely. Next, let us see the useful microorganisms or the friendly microorganisms. Microorganisms play an important role in our lives. Let us see each step. First, microorganisms are used in preparation of curd by the bacterium called Lactobacillus. These microorganisms are also even used in the preparation of bread by the fungi called yeast. This yeast is also commercially used for the production of alcohol and wine by the process of fermentation. And these microorganisms are also used in agriculture purposes to increase the soil fertility by fixing the nitrogen gas with the help of bacteria called blue-green algae. These microorganisms are also used in medicinal purposes, like the penicillin is a group of fungi which is used in preparation of medicines, like the antibiotics. These antibiotics are the nothing but the chemical substances that kill or stop the growth of microorganisms. These examples of antibiotics are the streptotrimethoxazine and tetracycline and penicillin. Now we have to see few precautions for using these antibiotics. Antibiotics should be taken under a well-qualified doctor. We need to complete the course prescribed by the doctor. We have to take antibiotics at the right amount and the right time. Next, vaccine. Vaccine is also prepared by the microorganisms. A vaccine is a substance that helps us to protect against some diseases. Several diseases like chlamydia, smallpox, hepatitis are prevented by these vaccinations. Let us see how this vaccination works. When a disease-causing microbe enters our body, the body produces antibodies to fight the invader. Invader is nothing but the microbe. The body also remembers how to fight the microbe if it enters again. In vaccination, the dead microorganisms are injected into the body. The body recognizes and reacts to these dead microorganisms as if they are alive and produces antibodies. Next time when the same disease-causing microorganisms enters our body, these antibodies will react and kill them. This is how our vaccine works. Next, these microorganisms can be used to degrade the harmful and smelly substances. They also play an important role in cleaning up our environment by clearing the harmful and smelly substances. Next, harmful microorganisms. Harmful microorganisms are the disease-causing microorganisms are called pathogens. Microbial diseases are the pathogens that are spread from infected person to the healthy person through air, water, food or physical contact are called communicable diseases. Next, when these pathogens are transferred from insects or animals are called carriers. These insects or animals are called carriers. Examples are female Anopheles mosquito, which carries malaria, and female Aedes mosquito, which carries dengue. So we have to take few precautions to control this malaria and dengue. First one is all mosquitoes breed in water. So hence one should not let water collect anywhere like the flower pots, the coolers, tires and etc. We have to keep our surroundings clean and dry. We have to use mosquito nets and we have to spray insecticides. Next here you can see the examples. Next one is food poisoning. Let me explain you the process how this food poisoning happens. The flies sit on garbage and from the garbage pathogens stick to their body. When these flies sit on uncovered food, pathogens may transfer to that food, making the food contaminated. Whoever eats this food may fall sick. This is called food poisoning. So when pathogens enter or stick to the flies, it may sit on uncovered food, so making the food contaminated. This food poisoning causes the vomitings, stomach ache, and even to the death also. So we have to keep always our food covered. Next, here are the few human diseases. The causative microorganisms and their mode of transmission and the preventive measures we have to take. So the first one is tuberculosis, which is the causative microorganism is bacteria, which is the mode of transmission is by air, and measles by virus, the mode of transmission is air, chickenpox by virus, mode of transmission is air and contact, polio by virus, mode of transmission is air or contact. For these four human diseases, we have to keep the patient in complete isolation. We have to keep the patient's belongings away from others. And vaccination should be given at suitable age. Next are chlorine and typhoid. These are caused by bacteria. And the mode of transmission for these both are water. So the preventive measures are maintain personal hygiene habits and good sanitizer habits, consume properly cooked food, and we have to drink boiled drinking water, and also vaccination should be given at suitable age. Next, hepatitis B. The causative microorganism is virus and the mode of transmission is water. For this, we have to drink the boiled drinking water and we have to take the vaccination at suitable age. Next human disease is malaria. The causative microorganism for this malaria is protozoa. And the mode of transmission is by the mosquito. The preventive measures we have to take for this malaria are, we have to use mosquito nets, we have to spray insecticides, and we have to control the breeding of mosquitoes by not allowing the water to collect anywhere in the surroundings, and we have to keep our places clean, neat and dry. Next, even these diseases are caused in plants. There are few plant diseases like citrus canker, where it is caused by the bacteria in the mode of transmission of air, and rust of wheat, which is caused by fungi because of mode of transmission like air and seeds, and the yellow vein mosaic of bindi, the okra, which is caused by the virus because of the insects. Next, we have few food preservation methods which makes the foods stay for longer time. So the salts and edible oils which are used generally to check the growth of microorganisms are called preservatives. So let us check the preservation methods by step by step. So first method is preservation by common salt. Common salt has been used to preserve meat and fish. Even it is used to preserve amla, tamarind, raw mangoes and etc. Next, preservation by sugar. Jams, jellies and squashes are preserved by the sugar. This sugar reduces the moisture content in the food item. Next, preservation by oil and vinegar. Storing pickles by oil and vinegar helps to prevent the spoilage of pickles because bacteria cannot live in such environment. So it is good to store pickles by using oil and vinegar. Next, pasteurization. In this process, milk is heated for some time, like up to 70 degrees for 15 minutes, and then suddenly chilled, that means for at minus 3 degrees for 5 seconds and stored. So this pasteurization was discovered by the Louis Pasteur. Next, storage and packing. Food materials need to be stored in airtight container to prevent the attack of microorganisms. Next, let us move to this nitrogen cycle. This nitrogen cycle, rhizobium, is an important bacteria which actually fixes the nitrogen in the soil by the leguminous plants. We can see this rhizobium in the root nodules of the leguminous plants. Now let us see the nitrogen cycle. First, we have two cycles. The first cycle will be fixing by the bacteria, and the second cycle will be fixing by the lightning or the thunderstorms from the atmosphere. This atmospheric nitrogen, first cycle is this atmospheric nitrogen. Nitrogen will be fixed by the bacteria or the blue-green algae, and then this bacteria in turn fix the nitrogen into nitrogen compounds. It turns the nitrogen into nitrogen compounds. This nitrogen compounds will be in the soil, will be uptaken by the plants, where these plants will be eaten by the animals. From the plants and animals' death or excretion, again it will go back into the compounds of nitrogen into the soil. Again, these bacteria only turn some part of the nitrogen compounds into nitrogen gas and send it back into the atmosphere. This is our first cycle. The second cycle is same atmospheric nitrogen will be fixing by the lightning, which will directly become in the compounds of nitrogen in the soil, will be uptaken by the plants and eaten. These plants will be eaten by the animals. This nitrogen waste from excretion and death again come back into the form of compounds of nitrogen in the soil, where bacteria turn these compounds of nitrogen into gaseous state of nitrogen and send it back into the atmosphere, by the gaseous state of nitrogen. That's it. So what we have learned in this chapter is microorganisms and their different groups, friendly microorganisms, harmful microorganisms, food and their preservation methods, and nitrogen cycle. That's it. Thank you. If you like my video, please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.